Hi, my name is Ruben Alves, I am from Robotics Ignite Academy, and today you are going to see how to create a ROS Service message, how to compile and how to import it. For that you are going to use this platform, which is the best one if you want to learn ROS really fast. Let's start here a course, so you can see how we do that. If you remember our previous video, we have been looking what is a ROS Service, and if you remember, in a service we normally have a message that defines that service with a request and a response. So to create that message we first need a package, so let's enter here on our catkin workspace. Let's create here a package, so catkin create package. The name of our package is going to be services tutorial, and it depends on ROSPY, because okay, here we have the service we are going to create. To create the service we on our package, we need a folder called SRV. So let's create a folder called SRV, and inside that folder SRV we create the file that contains the structure of our service. Let's suppose we wanted to create a service that basically sums two numbers. So add two numbers is the name of our service, and our service needs the extension SRV. So if you look here on the, let's open here this file and change the font size. So if you remember, we need a request and a response. So to add two numbers, we need, let's say, the number A, then the second number, and we need the response. So float sum, let's say sum. To create this message, we need the request comes first, then we have these three hyphens, then we have the response. In this case, our response is going to be sum, and the request A and B. So okay, now we have seen how to create a message, but now let's going to see how to compile. Let's open here the CMake list files. Change here the syntax highlighting to make file to make it easier. Let's see, here you have it. Okay, to compile a ROS service is almost the same as compiling a normal message. So in our package XML, if you see here on the line 34 more or less, we have here on our package XML, we have to add message generation and message runtime. So let's go there, package runtime. We have here message generation, we just uncomment this, and also the message runtime. Okay, so far so good. Now, if you keep looking here on the instructions, just to let you know, although we are looking the instructions here on the CMake file, we also have all the instructions here on the chapter ROS services of this course, so we can look more detailed explanation there. So, in this CMake file list, let's add message generation to find package, which is here. So, message generator. Let's also add here the standard messages. Okay. And if you keep looking here, so add message runtime and every package in catkin package. So let's see where is this catkin package. Okay, here we have it. So let's add here as a dependency this message runtime. So depends, because it's a dependency. Let's go back online 34 and see. Comment add asterisco, in this case asterisco means services. Okay, here we have. Let's uncomment this and let's put here the name of our service. If you remember here on the left side is add two numbers. So add two numbers. Let's see what else. Okay, uncomment the generate messages. Let's see where. Okay, here we have it. Just uncomment this. Okay, now we should be able to compile our service with no problems. So let's go to our catkin workspace and catkin make to see whether our package is compiled. Wait some seconds. If it's compiled, let's try to import just to make sure it was really compiled. So let's wait. Almost there. Okay, 100%. Everything should be fine. After compile, we need to source the devil folder. So source devil setup, the setup bash file that is on the devil folder. Okay. Now, how to import the file to make sure our service was compiled? We can run this command, Python command from, the name of our package is services tutorial. So from services tutorial dot .srv import the name of our service, which is addToNumbers. AddToNumbers. To make sure it worked, we print it worked. So let's see. Yeah, it worked. So easy, no? We define our structure with the request and the response. Change the CMake list and the package XML file. Compile and everything is good. So that's it, guys. This is the video for today. I hope you enjoyed. If you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. You can also subscribe to our channel and press the bell for a new video every single day. Thanks for watching.